I ended up in special ed as an educator. They're looking for a position as a teacher. And when I graduated, I was ill-prepared for what I studied. I studied graphic design illustration. I had a major in art education. And so when I left, as I said, I was ill-prepared for that business side of the illustration industry, so I didn't do illustration at all. I didn't paint for 8 years after school. And so I went into teaching. And at that time, the only job that you could get as a teacher was substituting. And so I did a lot of substitute. I was substitute second grade in high school. And then there was an opportunity to work at a hospital working with patients who were suffering from various psychological psychosis. But they loved me. They loved me coming in and giving them this outlet. And I loved being there. It got to a point, though, as an educator, as someone who loves to see progress, there was little to be had there at the hospital. It was became a revolving door. And so after too long, I needed something to make that transition. And children's books came in. And it came in a way that unexpected. I was approached by an agent, my agent Jeff Dwyer. He calls me up and says, you know, Mr. Lewis, I saw the artist magazine. You're on the cover, and there's an image inside of some kids. And, you know, I represent authors and illustrators of kids' books, and I want to know if you're interested in doing kids' books. I said, no. He said, no. I said, no, I'm a fine artist, not an illustrator. He said, what's the difference? And I went on to explain. And he says, you know what? You need to see what's going on in kids' books. I said, well, you know, I have kids, and, you know, they love Eric Carle and Vera B. Williams and Stephen Kellogg. He said, well, do you know who Barry Moser is? No. Do you know who Chris Van Allsburg? No. What about Jerry Pinkney? No. So you need to see what's going on in kids' books. I said, well, my lunch break, I went to a bookstore. I'm sitting there every day. I went there for 2 weeks straight, every day on my lunch break, to look at these books, you know, to get this incredible edification. And after 2 weeks, I was hooked. I'm like, I got to do this work. So I called this guy back, you know, Jeff, and I said, you know what? I misspoke. I got to do books. You know, I am like, I can't, how did I say no to this? This is an incredible world. Because what I realized that I discovered that some of the best artwork in the country is being done in kids' books. So I called, you know, so when Jeff said, look, I already knew you were going to change your mind. So I took the liberty of sending your slides to 9 different publishers. So we'll wait to see what happens. So I said, okay. So he said, well, you know, I said, well, I'm excited to get started. He says, well, you know, hold on, young Turk, you know, this doesn't work that way. Because I have artists and illustrators, authors and illustrators that I love their work, but I can't find manuscripts and, you know, and authors to pick them up. So we just have to wait to see what happens. Well, 3 or 4 days pass. He gives me a call back. He says, guess what happened? I said, what? He said, 6 of those 9 publishers that I sent your work to, 6 of them want you to do books for them. I said, really? What's that mean? He said, quit your job. So I quit my job, and the rest is history.
Funding for AdLit.org is provided by the Ann B. and Thomas L. Friedman Family Foundation. For more information on adolescent literacy, please visit us online at www.adlit.org.